This last week, I made a very big mistake that cost me a lot of money. I want to share it with you guys so you don't make the same mistake yourselves. I printed out a lot of these soldiers for a custom 40K unit that I'm making. The problem is they weren't scaled properly to my other minis. They would have looked weird on the board. The good thing is you can prevent this. Coming up, I'll share 5 tricks you can do to get your mini scales right. Let's do it. Hey there, I'm Danny, 3D Printing DM. Welcome to 3D Printed Tabletop, a channel where we cover all things 3D printing for your tabletop games. A lot of folks doing 3D printing, scale can be a very fun way to have some fun with your prints. But for folks doing 3D printing for tabletop games, scale is a little more than fun. It's really important. And for some people, a few millimeter difference really doesn't make that much of a difference. But if you're playing a war game or a game like D&D that uses measurement, which is in reality many tabletop games, you'll want the scale to be right. Or you just accept that, you know, your game might be affected or will just look a little funny. And that's okay too, but I think most people do want to keep the scale consistent as much as possible. Now there are folks who get really precise with scale, talking measuring from the base to the head, size of the head, things like that. I'm not planning on going there in this video. I think there are articles and other videos that cover this subject much better than I can. What I am going to show you are some very, very simple ways to just get extremely close to matching scale without using, you know, big measurements and complicating stuff. And you can do a lot of this before you print anything at all. So here's where you can start. The first way is to use a model that you know is already scaled correctly. So here we can see, okay, the models don't match. One's bigger than the other. So what you do is you adjust the percentage of the model in your slicer and you just get it to be the same general size in this case. Printable Scenery also has a few models you can use as a reference as well. Now the problem with this is that it depends on the proportions being correct. And as you can tell, Miguel Zavala's orcs have a little different proportion, as you can tell with the heads versus the arms, for example, while Duncan's are kind of a more traditional heroic scale with the exaggerated head, hands, and feet. Still, in my opinion, this would be pretty close and probably not very noticeable on the table. I put him on a base that makes him look a lot bigger than he is, which doesn't help the situation, but as you can tell, they kind of look like they'd still be in a band together. And if your mini's on a base, you now have a second simple option, which is to use a 1-inch base as a reference, or another mini that's on a 1-inch base as well. You know, you just scale the mini to the base like this, to that 1-inch base, and you're assuming that modeler modeled him to correct proportions, and you should be good to go. Honestly, mini proportions often vary from modeler to modeler too. So as long as you're in the same general size, you know, I haven't really noticed much of a problem for D&D and my D&D games. One thing you do have to be careful though is that just because the mini fits on the base doesn't necessarily mean that the size is gonna be correct. So we'll remedy that a little bit later with one of our other tricks. What if the mini isn't on a base? Well, you know the mini is gonna go on a base, so use a scaled base as a reference. So if you're printing multiple models, for example, like multiple orcs like I did in this case, as long as they're consistent in size, close enough, generally proportions aren't too big of an issue in my experience as long as they fit on that 1-inch base. So you are gonna wanna make sure that that base is your frame of reference with this method, and that they, no matter what they do, they fit. Otherwise you're gonna have issues like I had with this one where I have a spear hanging off the platform because I made him a little bit too big, even though his feet did fit on the base. Finally, another digital way and my preferred personal method is to use the anatomy of the scaled mini as your starting point. I usually start with the head, and if that still doesn't look quite right, I'll kind of make the bodies the same size, which is really the shortcoming of this method as well. It still requires similar proportions, and scaling won't change proportions, you know, only relative size. So comparing, for example, the Hero Forge mini to a desktop Hero 3D mini, for example, pay particular attention to the size of their head, hands, and feet. So scaling will get them to fit in the same size base and will be the same general size, but if you look really closely, this is why something will always be off, because this is a proportions issue, not a size issue. And I am bringing this home because this is always going to be an issue with scaling minis. And finally, if you need to compare it to an actual model, then you're going to use a mini that you've already printed, and you're going to use that as a reference so that you can then upload it and compare it to scale for that. This is another eyeball method, so it isn't 100% perfect, but it's a good comparison because you already know what the size of that mini that you compared it to is in the slicer, and you'll be able to adjust it accordingly. In order to save the money, this is probably what I should have done in the first place. I would have taken my Hero Forge mini, put it next to it, seen the size and say, okay, I need to get my mini to about the same size as my Hero Forge mini and see what percentage to scale it to, and voila, good to go in the photon slicer. And I'd know I'd be good to go when I print it out instead of having all of these minis that are mini, too big, whatever the case might be. Also, as you can see, again, the proportions aren't right, but the general scale is, and they are much better than my original prints. And I think they're gonna look fine as guardsmen for my custom regiment. So those are just some of my tips. What are yours? Comment below with how you make sure your minis are scaled, or maybe let us know if you don't care about scale at all, or what your thoughts are on scaling your 3D printer minis. If you like nerdy stuff like 3D printing and tabletop gaming, you should subscribe here and join me weekly. And also join us in the Tabletop 3D Printing Guild on Facebook and also on Discord and in our subreddits. Until next time, happy printing and happy gaming.